said, there's only two things in life that are constant. That's change and change.
It feels like something's missing, but I just don't know. It's like I'm not the same man that I was no more. And all these crazy places that I usually go are just not as excited as they were before. I think how much you constantly, it surprises me how I've changed. My friends all coming down on me, saying the player never changes the game. But those letters even never, never land. Right next to Peter Pan, cause nobody wants to grow old. Those fellas even never, never land. They'll never understand what it's like to be in love. Never, never land. Right next to Peter Pan, cause nobody wants to grow old. Those fellas even never, never land. They'll never understand what it's like to be in love. Like something's moving in.
Hi, I'm Jazmyn Clark, and I read the book Toxin by Robin Cook. It really had a good effect on me, a powerful one at that, and it made me think about a lot of things, such as, you know, families that are going through, you know, divorce and whatnot. It really can put a hassle on things, and being a full-time parent and, you know, having a full-time job, it can definitely weaken your awareness of things. And prime example being Dr. Ken Regis, he does this a lot in the book, and I feel like it was a good book, you know, and maybe it's, you know, a little too older and more mature for me, but I really got into it. It was really good, and I enjoyed it. Many things in the book, like how the relationships are, the different relationships between people, and especially Kelly and his ex-wife. They have a strong relationship for a couple that has been, that's usually, you know, couples that are divorced couple. They're very, very unsure about their surroundings since they've been divorced and things like that, but these two, they seem unsure, so I think I liked it more with that. And when I first started reading it, it was first, it started off with two men and they were in this truck. At first, I really had no idea what was going on. I was like, okay, this is really stupid. Why am I reading this? I was like, oh yeah, it's more for me to read. But as I keep on going and get into it, these two guys, they go to this farm, and as they're at this farm, you know, they pick up this cow, and they think originally, oh da da, that the cow is oh, it's gonna be dead or it's gonna be sick, but this cow is still alive, and at the same time it can move as well, but it's covered in poop. So they pick it up and they take it to a slaughterhouse. And as they get there, the guy's like, oh, they tell him about it. Oh, well, it's a cow that can move, you know, it can still walk or whatever. And they figure, oh, what the heck, we're just gonna, you know, kill it. So they kill it. And as they kill it or whatever, and it comes out and it's been completely stripped, the head falls on the floor. Now, when I heard that the head falls on the floor, I immediately thought about, says E. coli. So of course, because the cow had come out, this is where E. coli disease starts. So the office manager, or the floor manager for the slaughterhouse, he's like, oh, just wash it off, you know, so we cover up. And he tells the dude that tells him, he goes over and wash it off. They think that it's, you know, washed good enough, but it's not in reality. So as they wash it, he takes it and he puts it back and they go on with the wives. Now, Ken's ex-wife, Tracy, she is going to ask him for a weekend, and Ken comes to get their daughter, Becky. And as they come and get Becky, Regis, Ken Regis, he sees that Tracy is not really going.